is on the mound. He takes over for Derek Lowe, who was sensational. Six innings, one run, one hit in this game seven start on short rest. Struck out three, walked one. Doug Minkiewicz takes over at first to improve the defense. And Pedro deals with Matsui. And here come the Who's Your Daddy chants again. Two and oh. Commenting further on this strange move, Al and I were talking about it between innings. Maybe Pedro asked to come in the game. Matsui rips it down into the corner. Played off the wall by Nixon, and Matsui has the second Yankee hit of the night.
Sitting on a fastball, he got it. And here it is, the seventh inning, and the Yankees finally have an extra base hit.
Now it's Bernie Williams who homered off Martinez 2 days ago. He made the start on Monday, game five, but the Red Sox won in 14 innings. He left with the Red Sox trailing.
You can even understand if it's a two or a three run game. The Red Sox were up by a run, two run lead, a three run lead, but a seven run lead.
And by bringing Pedro in the game, you get the crowd back into it.
Yeah, right.
That's a foul ball. And it's 0-2 on Williams.
Well, the only reason why we're a little confused about Pedro out here is Francona talked about how they wanted to give Martinez an extra day. On his normal four-day rest, on the fifth day, he had certain numbers that weren't as good as sixth day. This would be his side day with 2 days off to pitch Saturday. I'm not quite sure. Maybe unless he went to Francona and said, look, I want to get real work with the umpire and the crowd before Saturday. I'm not sure. But if Timlin and Miskanic are available and okay, I'm not sure about this.
The 0-2. Williams hits it into right center field. Damon on the run. This ball off the wall. Back-to-back doubles. And the Yankees are alive here in the seventh, now down by six.
Williams gets an 87 mile an hour fastball and hits it hard.
Derek Lowe only threw 69 pitches and was rifling through this Yankee lineup. He comes out after six. Back to back doubles. There's the strength of Posada. And with Pedro on the mound, action will start for the Red Sox in their bullpen. Timlin.
And this stadium has just come alive.
Minkiewicz, that's why he's in the game. Ball stayed down, and Minkiewicz stayed on top of it. One out. Runner goes to third, that's Williams. And the batter will be Kenny Lofton. So you can look at it from two different angles. The effectiveness of Derek Lowe having thrown only 69 pitches, granted with short rest. And the other, the bigger picture, looking ahead to the World Series, is that planning too far ahead when you haven't won this game? Maybe so, but you have to be planning ahead with the World Series set to start on Saturday. It was a 7-run lead. Now it's a 5-run lead. John Olrud is going to come off the bench and bat for Tony Clark.
Well, breaking ball spanked to center field by Lofton. I think if you're worried about this game, instead of putting Martinez out there, leave Lowe in the game.
Absolutely.
And instead with throwing 69 pitches, I mean, how effective do you want him to be? How much more effective can he be?
Olrud takes a strike, 89 miles per hour from Martinez. Olrud homered off Pedro Martinez in game two. One ball, one strike. Three hits in the inning. One out. Pretty good rip for a guy who hasn't played the last three games. It's 1-2.
The irony of last year compared to this year, last year, whether to take Pedro out of the game or not. This year, whether to put him in the game.
Staying with the starter too long, as opposed to maybe not staying with the starter long enough. The 1-2. Timlin ready to go if Frank Connell wants to go that way. It's Olrud now, it's Cairo on deck. Go to Kenny Albert.
So much made of Curt Schilling prior to the series, talking about shutting up 55,000 New Yorkers. Well, I'm down here next to the Yankee dugout, and Pedro Martinez has woken up 55,000 in this crowd.
They are back in it. The Yankees are trying to climb back into the game now, trailing by 5. Lofton takes off, throw down, safe.
Jason Veritek did everything he could to throw out Kenny Lofton. Quick throw, strong throw, safe at second.
Two out, 95 from Pedro Martinez.
Talk about reaching back for a little extra. He certainly did that on that high fastball to Olrud.
Now it's Cairo. Good pitch off the hands, 93. Strike one. Timeout called at the plate by Veritek, who wants to talk.
Pedro's last three fastballs, the one that before he struck Olerud out was 97, just missed away. 95, he struck out Olerud, and the last one was 94. You wonder, you know, the pregame warm-up for a starter can be as long as 25 minutes, 20 minutes, 15 minutes. You wonder, did he get enough? Was the routine what he's accustomed to as a starter?
Two out in the inning and the 0-1 to Cairo. Well, he is letting it fly. This is old Pedro velocity. Showed you the highlights of that six-inning no-hit effort in the 99 Division Series. Game five at Cleveland. And he was throwing like this back then. Well, if he was holding back on the first couple of hitters, he has gone full throttle here with Olerud and now Cairo. Meanwhile, the Red Sox have missed a number of opportunities the last few innings to really blow it open.
Because of that, this is the biggest out of the game thus far.
Field, Nixon is there. The inning is over. Martinez gives up two. The crowd climbed back into it. Martinez stopped it there, and after seven, it's 8-3 Boston.